I see security teams making the same mistake over and over again when it comes to shifting left. It's frustrating from afar and infuriating when you have to deal with it day to day. Let's dig into the disaster that is DevSecOps. Now imagine for a minute you're in your kitchen preparing dinner. You're a reasonably good home cook. More often than not, what you put on the table is enjoyed by those that you're sharing it with. Sure, every once in a while, you miss. But that's the rare case, so when it does happen, everyone smiles, you laugh, and then place an order for takeout. After all, mistakes happen. Not too bad, right? Now, let's say that while you're getting ready to sit down for a wonderful home-cooked meal, your neighbor just invites themselves in. They immediately start hammering you with questions like, how sharp is that knife? Do you know who grew that broccoli? Are there too many ovens in this neighborhood? Taken aback, you politely ask, are you a professional chef? Do you have a lot of experience cooking? And they reply, no kidding, straight-faced, oh no, I don't even have a kitchen in my place. I just order food every once in a while. That's basically the scenario I see play out time and time again with organizations all around the world. The development team or builders are working to solve business problems and address customer needs directly. Then the security team shows up out of nowhere. And they start asking seemingly irrelevant questions and demanding that priorities change in the name of reducing risk and improving the overall security posture without really understanding what you're working on or even how you work. Now, this is why even the name DevSecOps frustrates me to no end. The DevOps philosophy already assumes that you want to build a resilient, reliable system. There's no need to jam another acronym in there. Teams know that security is important. They just need the information and support to make smart decisions at the right time. So is this whole shift left thing doomed? No, not at all. Not if you do it well. If you're on the security team, the first thing that you need to understand is that you probably don't understand how the builders are working. You can fix that. Spend some time with them. Ask lots of questions to better understand their workflow and what they're concerned about. Most important of all, make sure that the information from your security tools that do shift left provides information with the proper context and enough data for teams to make an informed decision. Just because it's a security priority doesn't mean that it's a business priority. Now, for developers and builders, understand that security controls can provide real value to you. The whole goal of all of these controls is to make sure that things work as intended. Network security controls, look for malicious activity and malformed traffic. You don't want that stuff anywhere near your app. Threat detection on your servers and containers is looking for errant processes and other indicators of compromise. This makes sure that your resources are only working for you instead of doing things like mining cryptocurrency for cyber criminals. Now, posture management, horrible name. Well, that looks at the cloud services that you're using to make sure that you've configured them in a way that matches your risk appetite. And vulnerability scanners, well, they look at your tech stack and they're trying to find known issues before they hit production so that they don't bite you in the you-know-what. Everything on this list and most of the other security controls out there can dramatically help you meet your goals. With that understanding, you need to make sure that you have access to the output of these tools. You need to know that they're in place and doing their job so that you can focus on the other parts of yours. Now, by now, you've probably figured out that the number one mistake I see security teams making when they shift left is ignoring the developers and builders. For some reason, security teams assume that to shift left means doing their isolated security work just earlier in the development process. Now, that's an archaic way of thinking. To truly shift left, you need to leverage the capability of security tools and processes to help developers and builders identify risks with their systems earlier in their processes. This data will help the teams make informed decisions about what actions should be taken to meet the business goals. Shifting security left can help reduce the risks to the business while improving the quality of systems you build. Now, who wouldn't want that?